Hello everyone, I'm from Rabindranath Tagore University, Bhopal, and my topic is a comprehensive review on rare earth based thermoluminescence phosphor radiation spectrometry. Luminescence means what? Luminescence is the name generally given to emission of light by a material as a consequence of absorbing energy. It is a Latin word which means light. So luminescence is the emission of light by a substance which does not resulting from heat, thus a form of the cold body radiation. Reaction: electrical subatomic motion or stress on a crystal is caused luminescence. Luminescence is the emission of photon mainly in the visible and in some cases in UV and in IR range, involving a radiative transition between energy level of a material. Depending on the different sources of excitation, the luminescence can be classified as photoluminescence, electroluminescence, catholuminescence, radioluminescence, chemiluminescence, thermoluminescence, bioluminescence, etc. They are excited by photon, electrical field, electric current, electron, heat and X-ray respectively. Phosphorus. Inorganic solids that give rise to luminescence, they are called phosphor. Luminescent material are comprised of a host matrix and dopant. So phosphors are inorganic solid luminescence material that can absorb some part of electromagnetic radiation and emit in the visible region. So the periodic table, the lanthanide series, here some optical properties are given: luminescence from FF transition, characteristic emission for each ion, narrow emission band, long excited state lifetime. Thermoluminescence. Thermoluminescence is the emission of light stimulated by heat, the basic process to storage of energy from radiation in trap, release of this energy by the application of heat, electron flowing from the trap to where they recombine with Hall. Recombination produces light with the wavelength characteristic of center. Real uses the band theory of solid and the amount of impurities are important. Application of thermoluminescence. Environmental monitoring with thermoluminescent dosimeter and evaluation of the system and a comparison to photographic method. So the next slide. Use of thermoluminescence as a method for radiation dosimetry of ionizing radiation and has many useful applications in various fields: environmental monitoring, medical dosimetry, space dosimetry, high dose dosimetry. These are the methods of preparation. Now, history of thermoluminescence. So in 1663, Robert Boyle reported to the Royal Society of the observation of the glow from a diamond when warm with dark. In 1904, Marie Curie reported the ability of the mineral fluoride to exhibit TL after being exposed to radium source. Further experimental and theoretical work was carried out by Urbeck in 1930. Randall and Wilkin and Garlick and Gibson developed TL model in 1945 and 1948. It is now about 60 years since Farrington Daniel and his research group at the University of Wisconsin, USA first suggested the use of thermoluminescence as a technique in radiation dosimetry. Now, mechanism of thermoluminescence. When ionizing radiation is incident on an insulating crystal, some of the deposited energy is stored in the lattice at defect site, color center, etc. Here it is a simple model of the thermoluminescence process. Irradiation with ionization radiation lead to generation of electrons and holes and trapping of free electrons and holes. Release of electron from the trap upon heating or optical stimulation of the phosphor material and recombination at the luminescence center leading to emission of light. So the next slide, research gap and motivation. Many commercial dosimeters available for use in radiation dosimetry, but these are applicable only within a specific range of radiation doses. Although researchers have suggested the use of high-intense phosphor CSFO device, this phosphor is not accurate due to variation in the glow peak at high doses. So another limitation was saturation of the TL signal in many material at higher doses. A need to explore more sensitive material that show linear TL responses over a wide range. Objective and scope. It has already been mentioned that commercially available thermoluminescence phosphors suffer from fading stability, etc. and these justify the ongoing need to identify factors that can be exploited to make a thermoluminescence phosphor with high efficiency and stability. So the objective of the present study is to explore new thermoluminescence phosphor mediated by mineral-inspired approach in combination with solution parallel synthesis. Now search for new thermoluminescence phosphor. So here substitution of one element of a particular composition by a similar size isovalent ion parallel solution method is given. Key points: substitution of transition metal ion by a similar size and isovalent ions are given, like iron, copper. Here the synthesis of new phosphor by mineral inspired metallurgy method based on searching natural mineral containing silicon from American Mineral Society database. Here see the first slide, American Mineral Society database. American Mineralogist Crystal Structure Database is given. So the second slide. Now a water soluble complex of silicon has been obtained. Water soluble complex of silicon, propylene glycol modified silane. Here ongoing reaction is given, tetraethoxysilane. React with propylene glycol, it will form propylene glycol modified silane, and this product is miscible with water at any ratio and it is non-volatile also. Research for new phosphor by two concepts are given. Now here pictorial representation of parallel solution method. Synthesis by parallel solution method is not possible without water soluble silicon compound, as TEOS is volatile. Now here selection of thermoluminescence phosphor. So there are many factors in choosing an ideal and useful dosimetric material for luminescence studies. So as one of the most significant compounds, silicates are extensively used as the matrix of inorganic phosphor due to their advantages such as easy synthesis, good thermal quenching, high chemical stability and ideal excitation and emission wavelength. Especially alkaline earth silicates are appropriate compound as radiation detector due to their water resistant and chemical stability, and exceptional storage luminescence property have been explicated for dosimetry.